And welcome, everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube, for an all-ranked day today. That's right. We are not going to be doing expeditions today, even though we have been doing those for the last 6 days. Today, we got four sweet ranked decks. That's what we're going to be playing. They're all, I guess they're all kind of new decks for us. One of them, Ethereal Aggro, I updated quite a bit and changed it quite a bit from the last time that we played it. So, it's basically like Ethereal Aggro version 2. What's up, Archdust Bunny? The expeditions, the drafts, basically you get rewards for the first three that you do. So I'll be doing those Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays for those of y'all that like draft days. So weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, I guess a four-day weekend. This is where we're going to be doing all rank stuff, except for not, I know y'all can't, maybe right here you see no stream Saturday. So tomorrow, no stream, got a lot of work to do and gonna meet some people and stuff like that. So no stream tomorrow. Let's get to these. So I've built two different new decks with the Freljord region. Because remember us playing the other day, we played the buffed elusive deck, which I'm gonna play again on Sunday because I loved that. I thought that deck was awesome. But it had Omenhawk and Avarosan Hearthguard. I really like both of these cards, and I think that these two cards can fit with just like all sorts of different mid-range decks, basically. I think these are two awesome mid-range decks. Look at this one card. 5 mana, 5/5. It's good stats. And then whenever you're summoned, every single creature in your deck gets +1/+1. It's just an anthem for every single card you draw for the rest of the game. It's awesome. And then, Omenhawk is the 1 mana 1/1 that's anthems the top two creatures of your deck. You get to play it very, really early. So we're going to be playing those with this one with some challengers and with Lucian. Lucian's a really good, aggressive, quick attack creature. So we got our three Lucians, our three Sennas. I use basically the rest of my shards to get the other two Lucians. Hey, what's up, Kendis? So we're going to have like our quick attack, big quick attack creatures that we're going to be pumping. And then we got a bunch of challengers. Challenger is just a pretty sweet mechanic. As y'all know that whenever you attack, you choose who blocks your creature that you're attacking with. So of course, the bigger the creature is that you're attacking with a challenger, the better it is because, the more things you get to use as removal. So we got one Fiora, we got three Protégés that are 2/4 challengers. A duelist can give an ally challenger this round, so we can give like our quick attack creatures like Lucian or Senna challenger. And then we have the Swift Silverwing Vanguard, which I think is going to be an all-star in this deck. If we were like pumping up the power of some of our creatures using Omenhawk and Hearthguard. Silverwing Challenger makes two different challengers. So like if they're like, two 3/2s, like that can be some good removal. So we should have some awesome ways to initiate combat. Of course, we got the one drop challenger as well. So that's a new deck that I built for today. So Lucian's challengers. Let's head on over to ranked and let's see how it plays. Pretty excited about this one. The sacrifice value that we're going to play later on, I'm also very excited about. All right, and we are in gold. We've made it to gold. Now, after a week, we got through iron and bronze and silver, and now we're in gold. And then after gold is, I think it goes diamond and then platinum, or platinum and then diamond, I'm not sure. But those are the next two, and then master rank after that. Yeah, the equivalent of a tempo deck in MTG. Yes, Ionia is basically like the tempo color. It has a lot of creatures with evasion. They call it elusive on here. I'll replace. So it has a lot of creatures with elusive, which is just like flying, and then it has like bounce spells, and so like some tempo elements like that. Yeah, absolutely. So like the buffed elusives deck that we played. Okay, so I'm on the draw. Let's lead with the tracker. what I use in silver, just the decks that I played the last few days. If you want to see all my decks, we got the website with all the decks right there. So you can see the decks that we've, not only the ones that we're playing today, but the ones we've been playing over the last few days. And then thanks, Kendis. And then also, yep, there's the YouTube channel. So you can see, you know, you can see the videos and you can kind of see like the records of the different decks on the YouTube channel also. All right, so the Omen Hawk gives this thing +1/+1. Oh yeah, so now this is a 6/5 challenger.
They would fall by my blade.
They're gonna be able to hit me for 3. They're gonna attack with this 3/3. I'm not blocking my Fiora. If my Fiora kills 2 enemies, then it transforms. And then if Fiora kills 2 more enemies, I win the game. That's difficult to pull off, but can't pull it off if you don't try. So I was planning on doing the Blade Keeper to give the Fiora +2/+2, but I like the Protege getting another challenger. Monkey clap. Alright, we'll kill here. Now I'll just trade now one, you know, the 1/1s. I was planning on having Fiora kill that 1/1, which is why I didn't want to trade before. This deck my opponent's playing, this is called Fearsome Midrange. Let's see, who said it? Death Grip. And I felt like this deck was really strong whenever we played it the other day. Played it probably about 2 days ago. Yeah, 2 days ago. Fearsome Midrange, it's really good. What's up, Joe the Magician? New home's feeling great. I got a lot done around the house today, so feeling good about that. Got a lot of organizing and stuff like that done. So I'm going to play the Hearth card because we want to play this thing as early as possible, because now every other creature in the rest of my deck gets +1/+1. I'm not going to play these challengers yet, or like this thing is challenger, this gives something else challenger, because they don't have anything that I need to kill. Basically, like the challenger stuff is basically our removal spells. I just don't have anything else to play though. Maybe I do play this Lancer. I mean, I could play this and give the Hearthguard +2/+2, but that's not spectacular. I guess I'll just play the Lancer. We have a barrier for protection. 3 mana, which is exactly how much we have. Convenient. They're sacking their creature, draw 2. Alright, well, I have 2 good big creatures in play and 4 cards, and they have 5 cards. So I feel like we're doing pretty good.
I know what lurks in the shadows.
is one of their champions. Elise. Ellis. I'm the worst in homeworks, waiting all the time in front of the PC at home. Oh, I know that life. It's so difficult. They're going Mystic Shot and Get Excited. So the Get Excited goes first to do the 3 damage, so I'm going to Barrier and protect from that. I guess I had to just Barrier anyway. I can't let one thing resolve. Whenever both players say okay to let the stack resolve, the whole stack resolves. So you don't let like one spell resolve, and then you can interact again, and then let the next thing resolve, and so on.
It is not armor that protects me, but my faith in Demacia.
I do love how like how much these characters interact with each other and stuff. It's really cool.
A cut above the rest.
You don't like Hecarim? Hecarim's really good. Yeah, I guess they can have Rasa. Yep. Alright, so then they kill these two. So basically, do I want to rally and attack again? And then basically, if I rally, Garen trades with Rasa. Kind of wish I would have gave the Hearthguard challenger instead of Garen. And then I put them down to 2. The rally means I get to attack again.
Our banner will lead the way.
Okay, single combat, that's good with us having these large creatures. So I'm going to, even though I don't have anything that died, so I don't get to draw anything, I'm still going to play this first and then play Banner, because I want to get that in play first before Bannerman. Well, just single combat, and then now they don't get to draw cards. They're trying to sack their Mistrate to draw 2.
Safeguard our citizens!
GG's. Let's go straight to attacks. Alright, well, that was a pretty good looking game. This deck is sweet. Only played one game so far, but I really like our deck. All right, and we got, I think, a rare wild card. Yep, so we got a rare wild card from the rewards. Reward program in this game is awesome. You get so much free stuff all the time. All right, so we're gonna play Lucian's Challengers. Let's go. Yeah, we're gold 4 now. Yep. Yep. So 1 week we've gotten through. Iron, bronze, silver, up to gold. Yeah, we're on the North America server. Yeah, I mean, Lucian's just a really good card, but yeah, the quick attack, I mean, he's just a good 2-drop, basically. I'm gonna replace these. I kind of want to replace the Protege also, you know, like, look for ones and twos. But I think, I don't want to just get a brand new hand, and then I get, like, all fours and fives and stuff like that. So at least, you know, setting the bar at least getting a, you know, having a turn three play of a Protege.
Don't get in my way.
Oh, we're playing against Ezreal Lux, so definitely playing against control deck. So yeah, they're going to be a control deck with a lot of removal. To break free.
Break their spirits and their swords. I demand satisfaction.
You have all Demacia cards and almost finished the P and Z region. Nice. Some good regions to go for. Cool thing is there's 6 regions. There's not a single region I don't like.
I'm what nightmares fear.
So going with Senna, because if they have like a Mystic Shot or something that's gonna kill my Senna, then I have the 2 mana, I can single combat and have these fight each other.
We fight for one Freljord.
We fight for one Freljord. Need to keep the single combat up to kill like Ezreal and Lux.
How'd you beat me here?
A lady has hers.
All right, so we have Lucian and Senna in play. So if either Lucian or Senna die, then the other transforms.
This is mercy.
Harry, report. You are toast. Hardly fair.
Well, they're down to 1. All I mean, if they would have played a judgment, I would have just killed their their thing in response. So 3, 2, 1. I'm going to try to, like, you know, hopefully this works. They have the 3 mana, so they could have protection for Lux, but if they don't have any protection, nice.
I'll bring them peace.
Lucian's mad because his girl Senna died, so he transforms.
They're out there. I'll spot them.
Get these sentries in play because... they, you know, they're a control deck. They need to use a lot of removal.
Nothing escapes my watch.
Who does not know the name Laurent?
So they use removal on these things that draw cards. So we're in a pretty good spot right now, but it's not like the game's definitely over. Ezreal's pretty scary. They need Ezreal to target my stuff 3 more times for Ezreal to flip. And then whenever it transforms, then every spell they deal does 2 damage.
Firing.
Lucian. Lucian!
All right, well now Senna transforms because Lucian died. Now it's a 6-4 double attack. Yeah. All right, so 2-0 and 2-0 against like the 2 most popular decks right now, probably. Like 2 decks that people think are like 2 of the strongest decks. GG's. Now we're up to gold 3. Let's go. Demacia spiders. This is probably like Dawn spiders. I don't want to just start at 3. Okay. Get a 1 drop. Omen Hawk. Yeah, Spider Aggro is like the best beginner deck for like what they give you right away to start with. Dawn Speaker is like a 3 mana 1/4 that whenever in Demacia, that whenever a creature dies, then all of the rest of your team gets +1/+1. And so I've seen that card from Demacia be paired with the spiders from Shadow Isles, but I don't know, like the Curse Keeper, that's not really something you'd expect in that kind of deck, so I don't know. That's the combo right there. 7 power on turn 2. That's the combo. I did Ryza. I used money here for the game basically because of streaming. I wanted to try to put together a lot of different decks, kind of, you know, so I did, but I don't think Like, if I was just playing normally, I don't think I would need to.
Break their spirits and their swords.
Not amazing yet, Kittles, but...
Run them through! Aha!
Still, it's a new game. It's not one that, you know, tons of people are playing yet because it's just too new. All right, so they get to draw a card with the Redeemer.
We strike.
Four mana. Not a great amount of mana.
Strength and grace, beauty in the blade. Harry, riposte, you are toast.
Let's play this first. That's a good way of putting it. This is the most balanced card game. That's a really good way to put it. That's really exactly what this is.
Today we fight as one.
I am not afraid.
So they're probably going to have one of their creatures dies, it does 3 damage.
I fight for the fallen.
Or not. I would like to swift combat here, but if they use removal in response, that would be devastating. So I'll just pass for now. Yeah, I agree with you, Crow King. I think this game's gonna keep growing.
You will be scoured from this land.
So I like the attack. Because I just want to trade my 6/3 for their 5/5. We're gonna drain one. Okay. Make a spider.
Can see the Demacian border from here.
I could use a single combat to keep them from drawing the 2 cards, but I'll just let them draw the 2 cards.
Today we turn the tide of war.
Harvey, my leg's falling asleep. Ow. That doesn't really help.
Let us settle this with great sensibility.
Hey, Arkalud. Doing great.
Avarosans, stand together!
Hmm.
I'll spot them.
They're pretty suspicious over here. Just keep passing. It's pretty suspicious. They're at 20 right now. This is life gain. But you can't go above 20, so this is gonna happen first. An ally detains another ally. No, I'm gonna have this ally strike that ally. Yeah, I expect them to, you know, add new card sets and everything like that. But yeah, new region and new champion. Yeah, I expect them to, you know, keep adding more sets and everything. Yeah, probably a couple months down the road. They got a lot of cards over there. They've got some good card advantage. The Redeemers have been nice. Of course, whenever these sentries die, we'll draw more cards also.
Look out for Reavers.
So the next set planned is going to add 6 new regions. So there'll be 12 regions. Dang. That's intense.
Justice will be served.
All right, well, our top two allies in our deck that we're going to draw are going to be real big. They're going to have +3/+3 from normal. Oh, man. That's like the best thing. Ugh. So the other thing is their creature is tough, so it takes one less damage from any source. So if we, you know, try to challenger it, we're only doing 4 damage to it. So that's annoying. I got it. I have to actually put these out here correctly. Drain one there. Man, how am I going to get rid of this 5/5? This isn't... I guess I don't really have a great plan. No, I want to do the lifesteal first because I want them to go up to 20. Like they're gonna go above 20. They're gonna gain 10 life, and then we'll deal damage after that. Ouch. Ouch. That's just a really cool part about the game, though. How much. How much combat tricks. Alright, how they're actually good. Use a lot of resources to get rid of this thing. But I'm gonna get rid of that thing. No, why do you want the lifesteal last? The lifesteal should be first, because now they're only going to 20 instead of 21. Like, they only gained 7 instead of gaining 8. If I would have done the lifesteal last, they would be at 18 instead of 17. Oh, before the back. Oh, you sent that before the back-to-back. Oh, sorry. That was the same from before. I'm sorry. My bad. All right, so this time, this one is not lifesteal and tough, so it's just a regular 5-mana 5-5. So it can tussle with our 1-mana 5-4. Our creatures are so big. Okay. Cool. Still got 5 cards, and all the mana in the world. Are you serious, Chow? In an expedition, you got an opponent to take 10? From Puff Caps and one draw with Teemo? That's amazing. We're gonna have big creatures, but they had good card advantage. They've whittled me down. I still hate Rasa even after the patch, yeah. Rasa's still good.
Strength in grace, beauty in the blade.
Yeah, it's transitioning to a different game. B-Roar. This new game from Riot, Legends of Runeterra, is amazing. Really well put together. What?
Stand and defend!
Why is that their block? Why is that their challenge? Shouldn't they challenge the 6-6? So they don't just get a free kill with Fiora? There's Dawn Speakers. Looks like they got me.
These are dark times.
Oh, I don't know, Lucian.
Don't get in my way.
They still probably got me. 4 cards over there. Okay, yeah, the Kinku Wayfinder's got you a second leveled up Teemo on the field. That is a really good combination. Get two Teemos in play. It's pretty crazy.
Boys, we got visitors.
That is just perfect. Alright, well, I'm just taking lethal here.
That egg, did it move?
GG's. Yeah, they outgrinded us.
Did not fall in vain.
I'm more of the... We're more of the, you know, we're like a stompy deck, basically. And they're mid-range value deck. And they outgrinded us. No, we're back to gold 4. Yeah, opponent did have more stuff than us. I don't have a judgment in the deck. I could definitely put one in. I have one judgment in my collection. I have like two of the relentless pursuits in here. I could put one judgment in instead of one of these pursuits. Because yeah, judgment is super powerful. No, I haven't tried a War Mother control deck. I don't. Yeah, like that deck, I haven't. I don't have like the cards to craft that.
Push back the darkness.
Yeah, that is true. Judgment. Like I only have the one Fiora. I wish I had two more Fioras with this deck, but I only have one. I basically had one Fiora and one Lucian, and I could make. And I had like space for two more. I had enough shards for two more.
There's nothing to fear.
But the Demacian soldier is worth tenfold.
For two more champions, and I made two Lucians.
Nothing escapes my watch.
Now you've gone and upset it.
I think they may be doing a lot of damage next turn. Yep.
A tribute to the fire god.
That was not good.
Let me change into something more comfortable.
We'll be able to use like the Vanguard on our turn. Gosh, that was just like a perfect hand for them. Honestly was. I can't block any of these other things. But 13 damage coming in.
You cannot stall judgment.
Well, that's really nice of them. I have to kill their 4/2. Oh, I guess they're gonna drain Garen for one, I guess. Skitter was perfect. Okay. They're gonna let me keep my 2/1.
My time has come.
So basically, in case they would have... Do I let them kill that thing? Yeah. I kept the 2-1 back in case they would have, you know, had like a lease or even like that 3-3 menace block something bigger. Yeah, taking this. And they have direct damage in their deck, so.
The War Mother will unite us all.
We're probably dead. Their hand was awesome. Yep, looks like we're dead. That fearsome midrange deck can be really good at times. And that's the same deck we beat the first round, though, but we lost to it this time. So 1-1 against that. All right, so 2-2 overall. All right, I'm definitely replacing the single combat. Maybe I'll just replace all these. Try to get a more aggressive start. Playing VZ. This could be the buffed elusives deck. My buffed elusives deck, I only have Zed. That'd be cool. Kind of looks like that. Come on, 2-drop. Yeah, 2-drop.
Nothing escapes my watch. Safeguard our homes.
That was good. Green Glade Duo.
Break their spirits and their swords.
They'll never see me coming.
All right, I don't have that 1-drop in my buffed elusive deck.
They'll never see us coming.
Oh yeah, there's definitely spells that allow you to draw extra cards, absolutely. Yep, there's card draw spells. Play Santa first. What nightmares fear. Yep, and yeah, there's like elite. Whenever I'm summoned, draw a unit. If an ally died this round, you know, this last breath, you draw a card. So yeah, there's definitely a card draw in the game.
In Avarosa's name.
So I'm kind of, they didn't play anything, which is pretty sketchy. I feel like they have, like, tricks here, so I'm just going to use my 2-1 challenger to try to trade with that. Nice. Instead of the 2-4. And I could attack with the 2-4. you know, just have a general attack, but I feel like... Yuck. Hmm. That thing's scary. Man, Omenhawked is a summon, also? That's pretty good.
These old eyes still see far and clear.
Hearthguard is my best card to play, and I would normally just be slamming Hearthguard. Master. But this Zed... The Zed's basically impossible to block. Or, you know, it's difficult to, like, you can't profitably block it, so we have to chump block it. So I'm playing this thing to chump block.
This will not take long.
Man, that's a lot of damage. Need a little more to turn the tide of war. Too many fours and fives.
Strength and grace, beauty.
It's not bad. Play. All right, so the duelist gives the Senna challenger. I hope they don't have a trick. So we can use that to kill this. We can use this to kill this, and I guess I'll use this to kill this. So it should just be us killing three of their things. If they don't have a trick. No, they had a trick. Ouch. Lucian. That thing's a 11-10 flyer? Good game. Wow, they buffed that thing up a ton. Those Omenhawks are good. Yeah, the double Omenhawk. All right, so it looks like the two Omenhawks hit like that, hit the Zed and then hit that other big thing. Of course, they played that one card that gave a creature in hand +3/+3, and obviously they did that card there. Ooh, we're playing against a burn deck. Teemo and Jinx. Keep one Vanguard. Vanguard is a removal spell for Teemo. Yeah, I mean, we have, there's three single combats in the deck. I haven't been drawing, like, I didn't draw any single combats there, but there's three in the deck. I haven't been super impressed with Detain or Purify. Whenever I was playing Purify, there's a lot of times that it was kind of meh. But Purify is better when you're playing a lot of creatures, though, because it's good in combat. When you're playing like a more controlling type deck, it's not as good.
I can do this.
Because yeah, you get to see what champions your opponent's playing, and so they're playing Teemo and Jinx, and Teemo and Jinx together is a burn deck. So you get to see what champions your opponent has in their deck.
Nothing like the great outdoors.
Strength and grace, beauty in the blade.
In position.
Yeah, Jinx in particular is definitely burn. We're gonna be playing a Jinx deck later with our discard burn deck. Jinx and Draven.
This'll shake him.
Don't mind me.
Well, that was a good call, though. The Purify would be better when you're playing a lot of creatures to take out the elusiveness.
I'll close my eyes. Make it fair. Better run.
Puff caps. So I got 5 puff caps. Every time Teemo hits you, you get 5 puff caps until Teemo levels up. And then it doubles the puff caps. Alright, so I want to attack with this, 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 and this. And I want you to block. Wait, where do you? You're Teemo. Yes, Teemo. You get blocked. You get blocked. Spooky spider. You can get blocked. Boo. So Lucian transforms if Lucian sees 4 of my creatures die. That would have been 3 creatures dying right there.
In position. Boom.
Alright, so we're taking 1 for that thing attacking. 3-2 here.
For one Freljord.
One Freljord.
I'll try anyone.
Okay. This will be 2-2 ones. Whenever I survive damage, deal 2 to the enemy Nexus.
Tribes under one banner.
Okay, should have the 3-2 kill the Teemo to play around Death Lotus. Okay, cool. I don't know really what Death Lotus is. What's Death Lotus? I don't have like a ton of experience against the burn decks, to be honest, or with or against. The 1 mana deal 1 to anything. Okay, that card. Okay. Yep. Okay, I know that card. Okay. Yeah, good call. Okay.
They're out there. I'll spot them.
Deal 1 to all battling creatures.
Oh, it is a great day for a reckoning.
This Jinx is going to be killing me. Super Mega Death Rocket.
part of the plan I just made up.
I guess we're really doing this.
It's the first time I've seen a Super Mega Death Rocket cast.
Smile. It's called gunplay.
I still memorize the card names. Yeah, me too. He called Get Excited Wind Up Monkey the other day. Alright, we need this to survive, that to survive. So that has to trade here. Ooh. The good news is all their stuff's dead besides Jinx. At the start of the round, they do get to draw two cards. I really want to just kill Jinx right away, even though I could probably put out lethal. I could put a 4-4, a 5-5, and a 4-3 in play. I don't know. I think it's worth killing Jinx, honestly. Where we're at in the game. Because if they basically Jinx, whenever they empty their hand, they get another one of those Super Mega Death Rockets. So I don't want to like play two things and they get to empty their hand. Because then, yeah, I would have been dead.
Today we turn the tide of war.
Yeah, I already had another challenger. I didn't want to give them an opportunity to empty their hand.
Nothing escapes my watch.
Save your worlds. We speak with blades.
Alright, so I'm taking two. Alright, so basically if they could draw a decimate to kill me. Oh no! Two puff caps. I had like hardly any puff caps. I had four total. And then this thing attacks and does two. Come on! Ugh. Wow. Wow. That was unlucky. Yeah, that was unlucky. There was four total puff caps on 26 cards. And of course we drew a card that had two of those four puff caps. My flying saucer driving pet looked unhappy with your performance there. Definitely did. All right, we'll keep this curve with the 1, 2, 3. Let's get the Omen Hawk in play first. Looks like another buff elusive deck. This time I got an Omen Hawk also. Last time they had two Omen Hawks and I had zero. So even for now.
Says you. Can see the Demacian border from here.
Full speed ahead.
Oh, if I didn't play that's true. If I didn't play the Redeemer, I would not have. That's a good call. I didn't even think of that. Let's play this first. Yeah. I didn't even think of that. That's a good call. If I wouldn't have played the Redeemer to draw that extra card, then I wouldn't have gotten the puff caps. Alright, got punished.
The Order rewards its fate. Let's move.
We should be friends.
Oh,
All right, we got Braum out of here. Now we still got the two flyers that we got to worry about, but we're gonna have two challengers that can kill said flyers. If they just play another Braum, we could just kill the Braum with our 5-4.
These old eyes still see far. Safeguard our homes.
Man, if I didn't play that Redeemer last game. Bounce.
Alert the villain.
Yeah, the dog's kind of snoring behind me. That's what I was smiling about.
Stay safe. I'll take it from here.
I'm what nightmares fear. Silent as death.
Who does not know the name Laurent?
So we have these two in play. Next turn, we're going to play this other challenger to try to kill their 4-3. Yeah, with the region reward, I recommend getting to level 8. Level 8 has the champion capsule. So I recommend leveling up to level 8 for the champion capsule. Wow, that is crazy. Crazy good. This has been rough. 5 losses in a row now. Yeah, 8's a pretty quick reach. So, like, there's one at 8, one at 16. But yeah, I recommend getting to 8 and then going to the next region, get to 8 with that region, and so on. May have to go back to the drawing board here just a little bit with, like, some... a little bit more cheaper interaction, like maybe a couple purifies or something. I'm not exactly sure. I'll go back to the drawing board a little bit with the deck, but I like our deck. It just hasn't been working out for us. I think I've been mulliganing like the interaction a little bit too much. That did not help. I wanted to find ones and twos. Also, I think we may need a couple of more two drops, like one and two mana cards. We have been kind of getting stuck with a bunch of fours and fives in our hand. Our curve goes, we have 7 1 drops, 9 2 drops, 13 threes, and then 5 and 6 with fours and fives, but so there's 11 total fours and fives, but it seems like, and there's 13 one and twos. It seems like we're drawing a whole lot more of those 11 than the 13.
They're out there. I'll spot them.
That's a good draw. This is just a good draw because, you know, it's a 3-2, so it's a clock that they have to kill. Whenever they kill, we draw a card. They're just straight up Heimerdinger control. Yeah, I agree. Yeah, I think I do need a few more. No, I mean that's definitely fair. I think I need a couple more combat tricks, or like frostbite. Like the one mana frostbite thing could be good. I think that's a fair assessment that my stompy deck needs a little bit more swift and silent, a little bit more combat tricks and stuff like that. All right, so they're playing this thing main deck. This looks like just the list that's on. I'll just take it for now. I want to single combat those. They have one mana. This will probably work. Yeah, on an extended break there. Black Bear. Yeah, I kind of figured they were going to just block here anyway, so they could use a bolt effect to kill my 5-4. So I didn't even pull it ahead. Because like, if they wanted to block my 1-1, we would have dealt 7 damage, and I would have been happy about that. Puff Cap Peddler. Get excited. Or, well, Mystic Shot. Alright. Saved it. One mana counterspell. Oh, I guess I should play the one drop first. I wanted to get that down to be able to attack right away. Another rally? This turn's gonna be crazy. We're gonna do a lot of attacking.
I'm a peddler.
Yeah, that's how you tell the card rarity. So this is green common. These are all commons. This thing's an epic. You know, so there's common, rare, epic, champion. That's your four rarities. So you kind of think of it like common, uncommon, rare. And mythic. Well, I'm going to attack again. You're going to deny it? That's fine. I'll just attack again. And oh, they get the zero mana 4/1 though. They probably get to play that though, don't they? So it's not game. What? Why is that their blocks? Why would the 4/1 not block the 6/3? I guess they want to kill the champion. I guess. Or the challenger. Yeah, the buff to elusives is a tempo deck. Yep. You can think of it, it's kind of like it's an aggressive mid-range deck. If you're going with aggro control, combo mid-range. Hammerdinger is really good. Try to finish this out.
And fire! Yes, again! Advancing collective knowledge!
Trying to finish this out. Yeah, so Heimerdinger, basically, this is what their whole deck's built around, is this card. It's one of the most powerful cards. Whenever they cast a spell, they get a free token, depending on what the mana cost was. So they played a 4-mana spell, they got a 4/1 fearsome token. Played another one, got another token. So aggressive decks are trying to win the game as fast as possible with a lot of cheap cards and spend more mana than the opponent in the early game. Control decks are just trying to stay alive and play big game ending spells in the late game. Mid-range decks are those in the middle. They can act as a control deck against aggro or act as an aggressive deck against control. When they get to untap with Heimerdinger, it's difficult to win, and now this is the second time untapping with Heimerdinger.
A fine spectrum of pyro
technique. So that's... should be game, because they get a T-Hex. That's a 9-9 trampler.
Nothing escapes my watch.
Because I can take 5. Yeah, I mean, it's just game. All right, well, we got something. Some kind of capsule. We got a... Oh, just a generic capsule. All right, two of our commons were upgraded to common wild cards. That's good upgrades. And we got a bull and a shatter and a battle fury. So we got one rare, two commons, and two common wild cards. All right, we'll move on. I guess I'll have to, you know, that's now six losses in a row with Lucian's challengers. Yeah, I guess it's just too many 3, 4, 5 mana creatures. And I need to get some more combat tricks in here. Yeah, like that's basically that. Maybe another 2-drop, you know, like our 2-drops are Sentry and Lucian. But like when, if we don't have a Sentry or a Lucian, you know, we're not playing anything on turn 2. Maybe we need another 1 or 2 2-drops. Yeah, I'll keep working on it. I think there's a lot of good stuff with those, but needs a little bit of work, of course. Needs a little bit of work. All right, so we're going to move on to Ethereal Aggro is going to be our next deck, a deck that I turning really, really aggressive. We're going to see how that works. All right, but that's it here for Lucian's Challengers. So everybody on YouTube, thank you so much for watching. Hit that like button and leave those comments. I'd appreciate both of those. Thank you so much for watching, like I said, and I will see you for the next video.